In this video, we're gonna compare all of the existing AI art generators that are out there. Everything from Midjourney to Adobe Firefly to Dall-e and everything in between. And we're gonna use the same prompt to make the comparison fair. So let's do this. Okay, so the first on my list is Midjourney. Now the prompt we're gonna use is a fairly simple prompt. A guy riding a Harley in Times Square on a beautiful sunny day. Midjourney is probably still the most popular AI art generator of them all, and it's a proprietary model and it works only on Discord, unfortunately, but the images come out in really high quality, detailed and photorealistic. We have four images and all of them seem pretty good. I really like the first one and the second one. I actually like them all, but let's upscale the first one, and as you can see, it's a beautiful photo. The background is nice. We have a little bit of blur in there, but we have details, reflections. We have some people walking there. It definitely looks like Times Square, and this bike definitely looks like a Harley. Now, the second AI art generator we're gonna use is Adobe Firefly. They have this text to image feature which just looks like that. It works on the website, don't have to go to Discord. So I'm just gonna copy paste the prompt. Now, as a default, the selected content type is art, but I'm gonna switch it to photo to make the comparison fair. So we are aiming for a square and a photorealistic image so that we can compare them all. But as you can see, that they're not as good as Midjourney, but probably this one is the best. There is something off about this image. There are some errors. The face doesn't look good. It looks a little bit still cartoony. But the good thing about Adobe Firefly is that it was trained on the data that they own the rights to, which means Adobe stock for the most part. Now let's use the third very popular AI art generator, which basically started everything, which is Dall-e. It was quite revolutionary back in the days when they started basically this AI art generation thing. But as you can see, the images are not really that great. There's a lot of room for improvement on all of those images. If I had to choose, I'll probably choose something like this. Although I'm not sure if I will be able to use it anywhere. The image is really lacking details. There's a lot of room for improvement. So I would say Dall-e is very basic. Although it's free, for simple idea generation, you can probably still use it. Now the next one on my list is the Bing image creator, which is powered by Dall-e actually. But people suspect is a much better version. The images are much better, yes. We have less errors. It looks more photorealistic, although it's still lacking the quality and the details, and there are some errors. The faces are not generated properly, and there are some issues. So if I had to choose, I'll probably choose this one, because at least we can see that this is somehow Times Square. Although I think the foot is missing here, some parts are awkward. Bing image creator is much better than the original Dall-e, but it does not compare with the quality of Midjourney for sure. From now on, we're gonna test more of AI art generators, but as you will see in a second, basically all of them run on a few models, some kind of a version of Dall-e or through APIs and so on. So let me introduce you to all of them so that you can make the right decision for yourself. Okay, okay, so the next one on my list is Blue Willow. In my opinion, is just a great alternative to the paid version of Midjourney. So I'm just gonna copy paste the same prompt and let's see what kind of results we are getting. Are they any better? Let's check it out. Now the first thing is that it works really fast. It works similarly as Midjourney. They have like their own style. It's more of a cartoonish. As you can see, it's a great perspective here. If you are looking for like more of an illustration or something for the website, like a series of images, this might be a good option. You can upscale the images that you like. Let's say I really like the third version right here. I'm gonna upscale this. It lacks some details. It's more basic. It runs on Stable Diffusion, so it's a different engine than Midjourney, but it's free. Next AI art generator on my list is the one from Lexica. So I'm just gonna copy paste the prompt right here. I'm gonna change this to square to make the comparison fair. Okay, so it definitely took a little while. We have those four images that have very unique style. They look like GTA, a little like this one. So I'm just gonna probably select something like this and save it. Overall, it's a great image. It's more of a cartoonish looking between an illustration and a photorealistic image. Now, the next one on my list is Playground AI. They have different models to choose from and different filters to choose from. But since we already run Lexica, which runs on Stable Diffusion, now let's run this on their own Playground V1 model. I'm gonna paste the prompt right here. I'm gonna make sure we have a square selected. We have some images. They're not as great when you zoom in on either of them. For example, this one, you're gonna see that it lacks details. They kinda unfinished, it lacks photorealism. On a scale from 1 to 10, I would give it no more than 4. Now, another AI art generator is from Dreamlike.art. And again, we have different models here, but I'm gonna use the most realistic one, which seems to be this one, Dreamlike Photoreal 2.0. I pasted the prompt here already. It automatically gives you some negative prompting, which I'm just gonna leave it there. And I'm just gonna change the aspect ratio to square. Let's hit generate and let's see what it does. It definitely works fast. Now let's check the quality of these images. Maybe they are not perfect, but they are not that bad either. Mm. You can see some problems. These people, they look similar, they look alike. It definitely lacks photorealism. Now, last but not least is Leonardo AI, which is actually the second favorite just after Midjourney. So again, let's paste our prompt. I'm gonna select Leonardo Diffusion. I'm gonna make sure we get 4 images. Make sure it's a square. So it definitely takes a second. It's already been half a minute and we cannot see anything yet. Just one tip, use this Alchemy, this new feature, which is supposed to give you better images in general, but they have different models. You can even create your own model. You can basically train Leonardo AI with your own images, which I try to do for my client with their own unique illustration style. And this is something for another video. But as you can see, these are the generations. They are probably far from being good. But again, it might not be best for photorealism, but it might be a good option for illustrations. Here's the comparison of all of them, so you can see the difference. That's pretty much all popular AI art generators that are out there. Which one do you like the most? Leave a comment below. My favorite is still Midjourney. It produces the best quality images as of now, the most detailed and the most photorealistic. And also check out my other video, how to use Midjourney for logo design, where I also explain how to set up your own server and how to use Midjourney and so on. And if you enjoyed this video, give it a like and subscribe to my channel for more videos like this one. Until next time. This was Arek Dvornechuck from eBay Design, and I will see you in the next video.